Hey guys, welcome back here. Crazy Dave here.
And the little coffee bean.
And together, we're going to make something really, really nice. What do we got for you? We've got some roasted carnival-style corn. But not just any corn. This is Crazy Dave style. Okay guys, so, little coffee bean. Tell our viewers what are the simple ingredients we need to make the roasted corn.
Okay, so right now we have some corn right here with the husk on it, or is that what it's called?
That's the husk, yeah. We kind of cleaned it up a little bit, kind of took off some of the garbage and a little bit of, I think they call it the silk here. But we're leaving the husk on for a reason, and we're going to show you that in 1 second. What else we got?
We also got one stick of melted butter.
Yummy butter.
And some garlic or something that's been smoked.
Or something, yeah. That is actually some crushed smoked garlic.
Oh, thank you.
Probably maybe about 10 cloves worth, give or take. You have to judge it depending on how many ears of corn you're going to do. What else we got?
We also got some string right here and some roasted corn aioli.
Aioli. This, we're going to use that when we finish off the corn. So we're just showing you what we have. It's a kind of an enhancement. So when the corn's all done, most people like to put mayonnaise on their corn. We're going to put the roasted corn aioli. But what's this green stuff here? What is that?
I have no idea. You know.
You have no idea what we put in there? Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, that's some green stuff. And no, it's not stuff that some people might think it might be smokable, but not at all. That is actually parsley flakes, okay? I guess it is smokable if it goes in a Traeger. I think so. But anyway.
So
we're going to show you guys, step by step, how this gets put together.
Okay, so right now we are going to mix this in with the one stick of melted butter. And there goes the knife. Great. And this, and we're just gonna stir it right there with the one stick of melted butter. That's not butter anymore.
Okay, so next, we're gonna grab the corn and we're gonna peel back the husk. We're not removing the husk. That's a key element. Just peel it back as much as you can. It can be hard, just peel it back, but not all the way, most of the way. Now, as far as the silk, don't worry about it. If it bugs you, take it off. But honestly, it's not going to affect what we're doing with the corn. Okay, but if you have to, again, just rub it off, pick it off, do whatever you want. Okay? You're gonna do this to all of the ears of corn you have, and we're gonna move on to the next step. Okay, guys, so the corn husk kind of looked like that. We actually did remove the silk a little bit. And you should be peeled back and looks kind of like that. Now, if by chance you end up with something like this, that's okay. Don't get mad, don't get upset, because what we're gonna do with this one, as well as if you should have, 3, 4, 5 of them, depending on how big of a family you eat, is we're gonna take this, put it into a pot of boiling water, and we can add the butter to it along with the garlic and the parsley and get the same effect as the grilled, but this one would be actually cooked in butter.
Okay, so I left one side of the husk on the bottom side, and I'm pulling back this part of the husk so it doesn't flip over to the corn side. And right now, we're gonna take this butter mixture, and we're just gonna put that all on there. Maybe a little bit more. just a little bit. And right now, I am done with this one right there, hold on. I am done with that, and I will flip this back over and put this to the side.
So we got the corn all wrapped up with some string, and we're going to go outside and cold smoke them in a while, so come on out and join me.